A very good morning to class 4. We have completed our chapter geometry. From today onwards, we have to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 4, division. This chapter is coming in your term 1 syllabus, so we have to complete this chapter. As you already know in class 3, there are 4 things which you need to understand while you are dividing any questions. So the first question, let's take an example of it. The first question is, you have to divide 5437 by 3. After dividing it, you get the last as the remainder. The answer at the end of the question is the remainder. The answer which you got is the quotient. The number which you are using for dividing anything, that is a divisor, and the number which you are dividing is now known as dividend. So these are the 4 things: dividend, quotient, divisor and remainder. These are the 4 things which you get when you are dividing any question. Now comes to the exercise part, that you already know these kind of things. But if you want to check your answer, this is a, you cannot check in the addition, you not check in the subtraction, you cannot check in the multiplication, but there is a method when you can check your answer in division. When you are just checking your answer, you have to put into a formula, that is divisor, multiply by quotient plus remainder. You are having the divisor 3, as you can see over here, the divisor is 3. You are having quotient is 1812. You just multiply both of them and then add 1. When we are multiplying both of them, we get 5436 and the remainder is 1. So we are adding, when we are adding this remainder, we got 4337. That is our dividend. We have to get equals to the dividend. Dividend is equal to 5437. So as you can see, you got the same answer which you are solving. So that means our answer is correct. But if you are not able to find this answer, then it is possible that your answer should be incorrect. You need to check it again. Now, in ICAN exercise, you need to solve it by yourself, because this is only just finding the quotient and remainder. Okay? Move forward, we have to just have a look on the division facts. Division, what division facts says? When a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. When you are dividing any number by 1, you got the same number. Let's suppose, look at here in the examples. This number 5 is divided by 1, so we get the 5. When 55 divided by 1, it is 55. When 5555 divided by 1, it gets 555. So when we are dividing any number, we get, when we are dividing any number by 1, we simply get the number itself. The second is dividing by the number itself. When we are dividing any number by, when a non-zero number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. So here you can see there is no zero in this number. We are taking 7 divided by 7, that is equals to 1. 77 divided by 77, that is equals to 1. This rule is only followed in those numbers which are not having zero. The result should be changed if the number is having the zero. Dividing zero by a number. When you are dividing zero by any number, the quotient should always be zero. See, here the example is there. These 3 zeros is divided by different numbers, but the answer should be always zero. Now dividing by zero, when you divide any number by zero, any number, the answer should not be defined, because we cannot divide any number by zero. So the if the question arises that you can divide any number by zero, it cannot possible, because zero is not a number, it's simply a zero. Move forward with the exercise part. This we have done. This we have to do in the homework. This is the classwork. This is the homework. This exercise is, this question is based on the division fact. So let's calculate it. We can divide a number by zero. Yes, we can divide a number by zero. See, here is written, we cannot divide divide a number by zero. So here it is written, we can divide a number by zero. No, it is false. Dividing a number by itself gets a zero quotient. It is false because here it is written, when we dividing any number by the number itself, so we get one. And here is he is saying that we got a zero, so it is also a false. Similarly, you have to do the entire exercise, and then we'll move forward with the next class. Take care, everyone. Bye bye.